sing ho for the mighty Peerless, as through the waves she steers. A bonny name for a bonny ship that surely has no peer. Can there be another like her, cargo bound for Britain's shore, on her treacherous journey into contract lore? In America, the cotton states were subject to blockade. For the fate of worldwide commerce, other plans had to be made. In the colony of India, English merchants solace found, though treacherous be the journey that came round. And the halls of British commerce saw negotiations bold, 125 bales of Surat cotton to be sold, and bound to arrive ex-Peerless from the port of far Bombay, a cargo of great value to convey. So sing ho for the mighty Peerless, as she plows the briney main. A gallant bark no match for her we'll likely see again. Her name being inked upon the page had given the call for her treacherous journey into contract lore. In October's balmy weather, it was she first set sail. Her hold was brimmed with goods the merchants contracted for sale. And owing to the faithfulness and skill of her fine crew, along the docks of Liverpool she drew. The merchant halls received the word she'd arrived from far Bombay, and the buyer with expectancy made haste unto the quay. As the Peerless spilled her cargo down upon the dock below, no cotton would be found to buyer's woe. So sing ho for the mighty Peerless, as she rolls upon the sea. With sails aloft and Britain bound, she harnesses the breeze. But not one bale of cotton could be found from aft to fore, on her treacherous journey into contract lore. But lo and hark, the Peerless, it's embarking for to sail, holding precious cotton bound up in 125 bales. A fine Bombay December morn saw her mainsail full unfurled, as she sought to journey halfway round the world. The Peerless tossed and pitched so hard as round the Cape she flew, when another ship was spied and hailed by her intrepid crew. So now as peers they plowed the swells bound for opposing shores, Peerless once, now Peerless nevermore. And once again in Liverpool the word passed with all speed, the Peerless had arrived and all with business should take heed. And the seller stood upon the dock full satisfied and bold, as bale on bale poured from the Peerless hold. But alas, the buyer ne'er appeared, seller's tender was in vain. The buyer long since covered other cotton for his gains. The seller's suit was filed then for contract breach he claimed, and the case went on to earn them legal fame. So sing ho for the mighty Peerless, now her voyage it is done. But in the law her legacy's begun. Though the merchants both invoked her name, it left the seller sore, for her treacherous journey into contract lore. Peerless, nay the gallant ship, was equaled by one more. For two ships by named Peerless sailed the brine to Britain's shore. On the merchant's fateful term to arrive ex-Peerless they'd agree, but no contract form that either one must heed. The words were fraught with meaning neither party could foresee, that each had meant a different ship to sail the rolling sea. Like two ships passing in the night, each one to the other blind, though words agreed no meaning of their minds. So sing ho for the mighty Peerlesses, as through the waves they steer. Bonny name for bonny ships that surely have no peers. Can there be another like them, cargo bound for Britain's shore, on a treacherous journey in the country?